Hello everyone, welcome to My Math Teacher. In this video, I am going to teach question number 9 from the exercise 7.3. This is for class 6 students from NCERT syllabus. Question is, match the equivalent fractions and write 2 more for each. So from the question, we can observe the left side, they have given fraction where the numerals are in 3 digits. Whereas the right side, it's all in the simplest form. Now we have to find the simplest form of the left ones. And then you have to match with the right ones. Let us start from the first equation, which is given as 250 divided by 400. Now you can see this can be easily divided by 10 because the ones digit ends with 0. Now you can divide it by 10. Divided by 10, both numerator and also the denominator. If you divide it by 10, it's very simple. You can cancel the 0. It will be 250 divided by 10 will be 25. Divided by 400 divided by 10 will be 40. Okay, now further we can divide this again. 25 divided by 40, we can see it is divisible by 5. This also divisible by 5. 25 divided by 5 is 5, whereas 40 divided by 5 is 8. Now this is the simplest form, which is 5 by 8. Now we have to write 2 more equivalent fraction for each of the simplest form. This fraction 5 by 8, we have to write 2 more equivalent fractions, 5 by 8. So to find the simplest fraction, it's a very easy way. Just multiply both the numerator and the denominator by any number. That is, you can choose any simple number. For example, I'm choosing 2 here and 2 here. So it will be 5 into 2. It is 10 divided by 8 2s are 16. This is an equivalent fraction to 5 by 8. The same way, we can give one more example. 5 by 8 multiply by 3, the same number I am choosing for the denominator as well. Okay, always make sure it should be of the same number. 5 threes are 15 divided by 8 threes are 24. Okay, the same way we are going to solve second subdivision. That is 180 divided by 200. Okay, divide by 10, divide by 10. As both numerator and denominator ends with 0. So you can simply cancel this. 18 divided by 20. 18 and 2, we can simplify further. We can divide by 2, divide by 2. Finally, we have got 18 divided by 2 is 9. 20 divided by 2 is 10. Okay. Now, this is 9 by 10. 9 divided by 10, we can't further simplify this. Keep it as it is. Now, we have to write the equivalent fraction for this. 9 divided by 10. Write equivalent fraction by multiplying both numerator and denominator by the same number. Always choose a simple number like this. It will be easy to find the answer. 9 twos are 18 divided by 10 twos are 20. The same way, find another equivalent fraction. So multiply and divide by the next number 3. Okay, it will be 27 divided by 30. Third subdivision is 660 divided by 990. Same way, divide by 10. Divide by 10. 0 and 0 will be cancelled. It will be 66 divided by 99. You can see it's very much divisible by 11, both numerator and denominator. So the answer will be 6 by 9. Again, 6 by 9 can be divisible by 3. Both are multiples of 3. 6 divided by 3 is 2. 9 by 3 is 3. This 660 divided by 990. The simplest form is 2 by 3. Now we can write 2 divided by 3. Find the equivalent fractions like by multiplying this into 2 into 2. So it will be 2 by 3 is equal to 4 by 6. So 2 by 3 equivalent fraction is 4 by 6. We can find one more equivalent fraction like this. 2 by 3 multiply and divide by 3. Answer is 2 threes are 6 by 9. So you can write 4 by 6 and 6 by 9 are the two equivalent fractions. The next subdivision, that is fourth one, you can straight away cancel the 0 and 0. Because it is divisible by 10. We have got 18 by 36. 18 and 36. When we see both the numbers, it is very clear we can divide both the numbers by 6. Okay. They are multiples of 6. So 18 divided by 6 is 3. 36 divided by 6 is 6. Again, we can simplify this further by dividing by 3, because 3 and 6 you can divide it by 3. It is finally 3 divided by 3 is 1, 6 divided by 3 is 2. The simplest form of 180 by 360 is 1 by 2. Now for 1 by 2, we have to find the equivalent fractions. Again, the same way, multiply by 2, which is 2 by 4. So one more example which we can give is multiply both of them by 3. 3 by 2 threes are 6. So we can say 2 by 4, 3 by 6 are the two equivalent fractions of 1 by 2. The fifth subdivision, 220 divided by 550, 0 and 0, you can cancel this. We have got 22 by 55. So it's very simple to find the common number which we can divide. It is 11 divided by 11. 22 divided by 11 is 2 divided by 5. 2 by 5 is the simplest form of 220 divided by 550. Now we have to find equivalent fraction for 2 by 5. The same way, multiply by 2, multiply by 2. So you can use any number of your choice. I'm choosing 2 here. 2 2s are 4 divided by 5 2s are 10. Now let's find one more. 2 divided by 5. For a change, if I am multiplying by 4, you can do very well. 2 into 4 is 8. 5 4s are 20. Okay. Therefore, 4 by 10, 8 by 20 are the two equivalent fractions of 2 by 5. Now we have simplified all the fractions which are given in the left hand side. Now let us match with the right hand side. So this is the first one. 1, subdivision 1 is equal to, what is subdivision 1? We have got 5 by 8. Where is 5 by 8? 5 by 8 is there in this. Okay, this is the answer. Now the second, 180 by 200. What is the simplest form? It is 9 by 10. Now we have 9 by 10. Here it is E. So 2 is equal to E. Now 3. 660 divided by 990, which is this. The simplest form is 2 by 3. So 2 by 3 is there in E. It is E. Now the fourth one is equal to 180 divided by 360 is 1 by 2, as we can see. Now here it is 180 divided by 360. Now 1 by 2 is here, it is C. Now the last one, fifth one, 220 divided by 550. It is 220 divided by 550 is 2 by 5. It is there here, it is B. Now as you can see, now we have matched all the equivalent fraction both from left hand side and the right hand side. Hope you must have understood this problem which I have solved in this video. See you in the next video. Until then, take care. Bye. Keep practicing.